How long have you been in the radio business?
20 years as of October 20th, 2017.
Did you ever do any of the behind the scenes stuff?
Yeah, when I started in this building in 1997, I got hired to work behind the scenes here when it was carts and nothing was digital. So I ran a board. I interned at FAN in New York City and then went to work at ESPN Radio. So I did that stuff there too.
You're a URI guy. You interned with the Fan. You were here.
Yep.
You were with ESPN Radio.
Yep.
How much different is each recording studio, one from the next, and how much has that changed over the 20 years?
Well, everything has gone from being done by hand and reel to reel to now everything's digital. So in terms of the studio, like the studio here at 790 is no different than it was when it was 790 The Score, other than the carts and the reel-to-reel machine is out. And there's a bigger console and the digital stuff is in. You can still hear everything through here, but for the most part, a lot of the studios are very much the same. It's just a matter of whether they're fitted for TV cameras or whatever. Like the studios of WFAN in New York, where I've done a ton of shows out of, they're always bigger and they have like a lighting grid. So if they ever had to come in and put in lights and cameras, they have a place to hang stuff.
With a loud voice,
yep.
How does that translate to the microphone? Are they able to adjust that easily?
Yeah. It's pretty easy to adjust. And, you know, there's the whole go up and come down. And, I've learned that even though I do boom, like that's the thing. My voice booms, but I'm always in third gear. And what I mean by that is it's like driving a car. You can shift up to fifth. So I can raise my voice to make a point,
yep.
Or I can lower it down. I talk into the microphone the same. I might turn it a little differently depending on whether I know I'm going to go up or down, or I'll back off a little bit if I know I'm going to go up for dramatic effect.
Do you trust the recording instruments today?
Yeah, I do. Now, there's the whole, you never know what could get sent out there accidentally because it's all on computers or whatnot, but at the end of the day, I do. In fact, I don't even think of it. I know how to edit a little bit. I don't know how to edit a lot. That's where producers come into play. And we make sure that normally if I have another person in the room because we've got to record it, then there's a sense of purpose. We know what we're doing. We go in, we do it quick, we get in, we get out, and they can figure out what they're doing with the audio. Monday through Friday, the Gresh Show, 6 to 9 p.m. on WPRO. Providence has taken back their sports talk. And if you are so inclined, starting December 9th, my national show starts back up on Saturdays from 2 to 6 p.m. on CBS Sports Radio. Whether it's the local show or the national show, you're going to learn something.